know, I remember first day back after Christmas break. Some grade 12s came in the TV studio and they're like, "Hey, Mr. French, how was your Christmas?" I said, "Forget the Christmas, man. Coronavirus is happening." Now, they thought I was a loony old man, as usual. They hadn't even heard of coronavirus. Like, what's the big deal? And I said, "It's going to be a game changer. China's building a hospital in like 10 days. They don't just do that." Well, I was right. And things progressed rather poorly for a lot of us. And now we're doing remote learning. And I thought, what's a good remote learning activity? So I signed a rant. And what do I get back? "Mr. French, I can't think of something to rant about. I don't know what to say." And I was like, "I can't think of what not to rant about." So I thought I'd show them.
Monday, June 1st, and here are today's top news stories. Over the last few weeks, we've had a handful of students in the building working with teachers. Today, we say welcome back to about 50, and we say welcome back to over 250 this week who have indicated they will be participating in in-class learning until June 19th. Now to our station manager, John, over to you.
Thanks, Jeff. Today's a great day. I'm excited to have some students back as we start in-class learning. We do have some strict protocols in place, and I just want to remind people of that. Grade 8s, when you come to the school, you come to the main entrance. And when you come to the entrance, you're going to be greeted by staff, you're going to be asked a few questions, and then we'll kind of give you some directions as to where you go. Make sure that you've signed up using schoolappointments.com before you come to the school. Grade 9s, you guys are coming in the theater entrance. Okay, so theater entrance for grade 9s, main entrance for grade 8s, 9 o'clock start. Try not to show up too early, but you'll be outside until we start bringing people into the building through some protocols. If you're not feeling well, if you're feeling sick in any way, shape, or form, please stay home. You're not coming to school if you have not booked already. Those people who indicated that they weren't coming, and decide you change your mind and you do want to come to school, please reach out, send an email or call the school, and we'll try and book you in for next week. In the afternoon, starting at noon, we're going to have our grade, grade 11s and 12s to the main foyer. You come in the main entrance, and grade 10s, you're going to come to the theater. So grade 10s in the theater, grade 11, 12 in the main entrance, and everybody, if you're going to book, you book your half day, and you book for 2 half days over the course of the week. You do it through bss.schoolappointments.com. Now I want to talk about grad. The schedule has been released, so if you haven't seen it, look for it. There's a link in the Bobcat Den, and we emailed it out directly to grade 12s. So just make sure that you know when you're supposed to be coming. The other thing that's important for you is to know what number you are listed at your particular session, because when we organize you outside of the main entrance for your grad session, the number is going to be important. So you need to remember that as well. We got a little bit of time until grad happens. It's about a week and a bit away. So I will come back to you next week a little bit more on grad, but I want you to plan to be there 5 to 10 minutes before. People are limited to 2 guests maximum. And those should have been pre-registered, so I would have that information already. If you need to make changes, then you need to contact me directly. Finally, grads, we are going to have a rehearsal. That will take place on Wednesday of this week in the morning. Whether we do it, I haven't exactly ironed out the details, but we'll communicate out to you. It's either going to be a Teams event where all the grads are on listening, or we will post a video of what's going to happen to walk you through what grad will look like. So it's kind of your virtual grad rehearsal, so you know what to expect when the date comes. Remember, June 10th and 11th is coming soon. Thanks, everybody.
That's great, John. Nice to get some energy back in the building. Lisa, how's traffic looking out there? Thank you, Lisa. As lockdown lifts and we start to get back to our new normal, there has been a lot of coverage about the psychological effects of social isolation. We've actually put a team together here at BNN to help us get through these times. Take a look.
There are more captive tigers in the U.S. than there are in the wild.
Soon be gone, so you better take a picture. What a sad, sad song. Call it Armageddon. Such a painful.
Don't have a sewing machine at home? No problem. Just use your stapler.
First up, the always reliable, nod and smile. Secondly, the appreciative chuckle. Third, the fake cry. You'll notice that the turn away is an excellent technique because it covers the fact that you're not actually producing any tears. And then, of course, lastly, when somehow it appears like none of your assignments have been handed in, the surprise.
Door stops. Not only good for opening doors, but for keeping people out.
Where, you know, we all are supposed to wear our masks for COVID, or at least suggested to. And I thought, well, you know, we never get to see someone's face. So why not paint one on?
Especially during this time of COVID, thought it was totally appropriate to teach you how to throw a pot.
So to begin, what you do is you get a pot. You hold it above your head, and you roar.
Roar!
That's how you throw a pot.
It's 7 o'clock.
What can an old guy like me rant about? I thought, well, got this dog here who's doing so much better because she gets like 3 walks a day, like most other dogs out there. Problem is, they get walked by owners. Owners like this turd who thought, I know what I'll do. I'll let my dog take a dump and then I'll put it in a bag and leave it on the side of the road for everyone to see forever. Congratulations. That's a rant.
That's great information, and thank you everybody from the Fine Arts Department. Last check with weather, Lisa.
Oh, yeah. Hey, thanks, Jeff. The weather today is pretty amazing. Keep up with that remote learning.
Thank you, Lisa. That's all the time we have for this week. Until next week, thank you. Stay safe, Bobcats.